If you were to spend $5,000 on a computer, what would you want it to be? When it comes to the iMac Pro, Apple says it just needs to be pretty, quiet, and have a ton of professional processing power. But if you're looking for upgradability and expandability, this device might not be the one that you're looking for, but it is the first pro-level Mac since 2013, so today, we're gonna tear down the new iMac Pro. The higher price tag hasn't changed the opening procedure on this iMac. I'm gonna pull out my pizza cutter, AKA our iMac opening tool, to cut away the adhesive around the display, and then I'll grab some heavy suction cups to help me lift the display off. The iMac Pro's display uses the same panel we found on the iMac 5K, an LG-made 27-inch display with a resolution of 5120 by 2880. But you won't be able to swap the displays between the Pro and the 5K as the cabling arrangement and webcam hardware have been moved around. Before we get any further, let's take a moment to appreciate this interior. For a company that does whatever they can do to discourage people from opening their devices, Apple never fails to design some beautiful interiors. And now let's start taking the pieces out. First up, the fan. This enormous dual fan cooler is held in place by just a few screws and is part of Apple's new thermal management design. While it provides an 80% increase in cooling capacity, we lose the external RAM access hatch in favor of a giant rear vent. The logic board comes out next, and while the AirPort card functions have been consolidated into the board, we still get a removable SSD in the form of these two PCIe-based 512GB SSDs. We've also got some standard 288-pin DDR4 ECC RAM sticks, which means expanding your RAM is possible, but getting to them is a major undertaking. But for those brave fixers out there who want to max out their RAM, you can use our iMac Pro Memory Maxer Kit to boost your RAM up to 128 gigs. Underneath the enormous heatsink, we find the GPU, which is sadly soldered in place, and on the other side, a workstation-class Xeon processor, which can be removed. Whether or not CPU upgrades are possible remains to be seen, since this does seem to be a custom-made for Apple by Intel processor, but theoretically, it is possible. Lastly, we're left with the 500-watt power supply and the enhanced stereo speakers, which according to some early reports, live up to the hype of being the best-sounding speaker you can get on a Mac. And with everything out of the iMac, it's time to talk repairability. The iMac Pro scored a 3 out of 10. On the upside, the RAM and CPU are both modular, meaning repairs and upgrades are a go. The dual SSDs are modular, but they're custom made by Apple. Cutting the tape to open the iMac isn't too hard with the right tools, but it must then be replaced to complete any repair. And on the downside, key replaceable components are buried behind the logic board, requiring a ton of disassembly for access. The loss of the external RAM access hatch makes for much more challenging upgrades compared to the 27-inch iMac 5K. And lastly, the GPU is VGA soldered in place, potentially a major drawback on a Pro workstation. No easy upgrades here, so choose your configuration wisely. That's all for this huge teardown. Be sure to hit that subscribe button, give us a like on Facebook, and don't forget to follow us on Twitter @iFixit. Happy fixing!